Hello everyone, welcome to Math Cyberspace. This is Dipendu Gonai and here I am with you with the biography of a legend who was a French mathematician, engineer and physicist who made pioneering contributions to several branches of mathematics, including mathematical analysis and quantum mechanics. Augustin Louis Cauchy pioneered the study of analysis, both real and complex, and the theory of permutation groups. He also researched in convergence and divergence of infinite series, differential equations, determinants, probability, and mathematical physics. Cauchy was born on 21st August in 1789 in Paris, France. Paris was a difficult place to live in when Augustin Louis was a young child due to the political events surrounding the French Revolution. When he was 4 years old, his father, fearing for his life in Paris, moved his family to Arcueil. They soon returned to Paris and Cauchy's father was active in the education of young Augustin Louis. Laplace and Lagrange were visitors at the Cauchy's family home, and Lagrange in particular seems to have taken an interest in young Cauchy's mathematical education. Lagrange advised Cauchy's father that his son should obtain a good grounding in language before starting a serious study of mathematics. In 1802, Augustin Louis entered in a school where he spent 2 years studying classical languages. From 1804, Cauchy attended classes in mathematics and he took the entrance examination Polytechnique in 1805. In 1807, he graduated from Polytechnique and entered an engineering school. In 1810, Cauchy took up his first job in Cherbourg to work on port facilities for Napoleon's English invasion fleet. It was a busy time for Cauchy. Writing home about his daily duties, he said, "I get up at 4 o'clock each morning and I am busy from then on. I do not get tired of working. On the contrary, it invigorates me and I am in perfect health." In addition to his heavy workload, Cauchy undertook mathematical researches and he proved in 1811 that the angles of a convex polyhedron are determined by its faces. He submitted his first paper on this topic. Then, encouraged by Legendre, he submitted a further paper on polygons and polyhedral in 1812. Cauchy felt that he had to return to Paris if he was to make an impression with mathematical research. In September of 1812, he returned to Paris after becoming ill. It appears that the illness was not a physical one and was probably of a psychological nature, resulting in severe depression. Back in Paris, Cauchy investigated symmetric functions and submitted a memo on this topic in November 1812. This was published in the Journal of École Polytechnique in 1815. However, he was supposed to return to Cherbourg in February 1813 when he had recovered his health, and this did not fit with his mathematical ambitions. An academic career was what Cauchy wanted and he applied for a post in the Bureau des Longitudes. He failed to obtain this post, Legendre being appointed. He also failed to be appointed to the geometry section of the institute. Cauchy obtained further sick leave, having unpaid leave for 9 months. Then Cauchy was able to devote himself entirely to research for a couple of years. In 1817, when Biot left Paris, Cauchy filled his post at the College de France. There he lectured on the methods of integration which he had discovered but not published earlier. Cauchy was the first to make a rigorous study of the conditions for convergence of infinite series, in addition to his rigorous definition of an integral. His text, Cours d'Analysis, in 1821 was designed for students at École Polytechnique and was concerned with developing the basic theorems of the calculus as rigorously as possible. He began a study of the calculus of residues in 1826. In 1829, he defined for the first time a complex function of a complex variable. Cauchy did not have particularly good relations with other scientists. He would bring religion into his scientific work. As for example, he did on giving a report on the theory of light in 1824. When he attacked the author for his view that Newton had not believed that people had souls. By 1830, the political events in Paris and the years of hard work had taken their toll and Cauchy decided to take a break. He left Paris in September 1830, after the Revolution of July, and spent a short time in Switzerland. In 1833, Cauchy went from Turin to Prague in order to follow the Charles Stein and to tutor his grandson. While in Prague, Cauchy had one meeting with Bolzano, at Bolzano's request, in 1834. There are discussions on how much Cauchy's definition of continuity is due to Bolzano. Cauchy returned to Paris in 1838 and regained his position at the Academy, but not his teaching positions, because he had refused to take an oath of allegiance. The year 1848 was the year of revolution all over Europe. Revolutions broke out in numerous countries, beginning in France. Cauchy remained a professor at the university until his death at the age of 67. He received the last rites and died of a bronchial condition at 4 a.m. on 23rd May 1857. His contributions in mathematical field such as wave theory, mechanics, elasticity, number theory, complex functions are always admirable. Okay, thanks for today. Next week I will be here with another legend's biography. Till then, be happy and healthy. Thank you.